Hello everyone, welcome to Crunch Today. Today's hot topic is reopening of the gyms, but the question is how and when. Gyms are the backbone of the fitness industry and also play a massive role in building healthy individuals and improving immunity to fight deadly viruses such as COVID-19. According to the experts, the virus will be here for some time, but we will have to restart our daily routine following a new set of rules. I am Gitanjali Mangal, and today with us we have Ms. Richa Mishra, who is the franchisee support manager of Anytime Fitness, which is amongst the largest gym chains in India. Along with her, we also have Mr. Alok Shirodkar, who is the CEO of Crunch Today, and who will also discuss the standard operating procedures in detail and what steps are to be taken to reopening the facility.
Yeah, hi Richa.
Hi, Alok.
Hi, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
So, I had a few questions, which we were getting from the members as well as on our social media, that how are we going to, kickstart the gyms? Because there are a lot of concerns about the safety and, the cleanliness and the new ways to cope up with this virus, So, first I wanted to ask you is, what measures is the gym taking to ensure the members that, everything will be okay?
Sure, Alok. This COVID-19 has made everyone realize a lot of things, and so does our industry. It is imperative to avoid any kind of exposure through physical contact, surface contamination, droplet infection, coughing, sneezing, and spreading via hands and other touch points. So clearly what we are trying to eliminate here is going to be the touch points. Gyms are for sure trying to, these are the places where you can build your immunity by exercising, by improving your lifestyle and being working out regularly. That is known to everyone that it helps us build our immunity and make us healthy. It helps us improve our cardiovascular health as well as, it boosts our immunity as well. And also, gyms are important because these are the places where you can get that sort of a professional guidance that can help you achieve the goal that you want to achieve within a facility. Hygiene remains the topmost priority, something that we talked about earlier as well, but now has taken the front seat. Before anything else, the first thing that we want to make sure is trying to eliminate any kind of contamination or exposure through physical contact or surface contamination. So all the Anytime Fitness clubs have been provided with a reopening guideline that has all the measures that has to be taken at the gym premises to make sure that the members are not getting any infection within the facility. And we are trying to make sure that by doing the decontamination using WHO or ICMR approved, the sanitization products which are available in the market. We would want to keep our members safe and secure, and we would want to provide them with the facility with assurance that they are completely secure within our premises.
Okay, and what are the proposed social distancing norms for Anytime Fitness?
Alok, social distancing norm for Anytime Fitness are going to be same as provided by government. So what we are trying to do within our facility is manage crowd control. We all are aware that in gyms, the crowd has to be managed. Social distancing means that in a particular closed space, you're not supposed to have more people, so that which can increase the chance or risk to get contamination from other different people. So the first thing that we have done as a brand is to keep a system in place, which is going to be a member reservation system, which will allow our members to come at a particular slot or a time by booking. And we are aware, we have complete control over how many people are there in our facility, and we can do capping on that. So social distancing is something that we need to maintain as humans, but as a club, we have it everywhere. It is a change that we need to bring in everyone's life, including me and you. It is a reminder is needed, you know, because we have a habit of touching our face, shaking hands, doing whatnot. That leads to infection. That is why that, as we were just discussing, and you were saying that we are safe at home because we tend to make mistakes.
Yeah.
So if you have reminders in front of you, we are trying to place various in-house posters which will keep reminding people to maintain safe distance. Also, there are different, you know, the staff will be there who will keep on reminding and doing their job, because we want people to be healthy for sure. That is the primary intent of all the gym owners, that, you know, we would like to contribute as doctors are doing, as other health workers are doing. We are also a part of the facility, and we would want to prevent people from getting infection and get better.
So, Richa, since you mentioned all these measures, what kind of protocols will be followed in order to keep all these safety checks?
Okay, so as I was mentioning about, we have a reopening guide which has all the protocols mentioned in it for making it easy and standardized within all the clubs of Anytime Fitness. We have checklist which is already provided to all the franchisees, because we are now trying to be ready to open our doors for our members. So at the same time, I would also like to tell you the process. A member needs to book his slot with the gym, the app which is Arogya Setu is compulsory. We would also want to maintain sanitization within the facility. That means that once you've used it, either the house, there will be gym wipes inside the facility, either you can clean it yourself or the housekeeping staff will be doing their drills at regular interval of time. We will have restricted number of people within a group class as well. So it's all about controlling the crowd and trying to maintain, you know, we need to understand how we can maintain that sanitization within the facility. And hygiene has been the top priority and will remain there for all the AF clubs.
So since you said that, you know, you are all ready and all the doors are open for the people, what will be the operating hours of the gym?
So we are trying to prepare ourselves. We are not yet ready, and we'll wait for the government norms to allow us to open our doors. And once we get the green signal from the government, we would still want to continue to clean our facility, do the deep cleaning, and, you know, because the facilities are closed for a longer time, we would like to do the deep cleaning, maintenance of the equipment and everything is done. Then we will open the door for our members so that they can enter a neat and clean facility without any issue. They can work out within our facilities. And about the question that you asked, we would want our trainers, our members, and our staff to understand their responsibility in maintaining and in contaminating the job that government has already done by keeping us in lockdown. We need to now, you know, do our bit and keep each other safe. And that's the responsibility that we would want everyone to take care of. Yeah.
Richa, what about, gym floor and everything is fine, but what about the toilets? Because that is the major, point of concern.
Yes. So, Alok, we have private showers. So, in our facility, we do not have common toilets. So, but in private showers as well, we do not want people to spend more time or in getting ready and all that. I know it is going to be a change that all our members will be experiencing, but I can assure them that it is going to be for their benefit. We'll not open the shower facility, and we will let them use the washrooms, and it will be cleaned after every usage. It will be cleaned, sanitized for the next person to use. And we, as I mentioned, that we were also earlier also, we used to take care of the safe seats and all that stuff used to be there in our facilities earlier as well. Now it will be regular thorough cleaning post every usage. so that, because that I understand can be a concern for many. So I would like to assure all the people who would want to visit the facility that they can, you know, trust the place. They can go and experience it themselves once it is open.
So how do you plan to inform the members about these new rules, since you rightly said that it is going to be a good amount of change for them as well? So how do you plan to tell them that you have to follow these rules?
So Geetanjali, I know it is going to be a difficult task, initially for all of us to adhere to all these rules and regulations. We were a happy place. We were a place where people used to come and have a lot of fun. But now things has to change looking at the current situation. So the communication to all our members will be done via various mediums like email, WhatsApp. We have infographics that will be shared with the members about each and every protocol that they are supposed to mention. I know that it is a change for them to adapt to, and we as a brand would want to make it as smooth as possible. We would also we empathize with all of them that they have to, go through all these things, all these changes. But as a community, we would want to help them do it in the best possible manner by making it easy for them to, be it reservation, be it understanding the cleanliness part. We will have infographics. We'll share it on social media. We'll share it. All the staff members are already connected to the club staff. So that's one positive part that we have. We know our members. So we'll definitely be informing them using all these mediums that are available to us. And I'm sure as a part of a big AF family, they will also understand why we are doing what we are doing, and they will for sure help us achieve our goal.
This was about the members, but what about the staff? Is there any special training that is going to happen in terms of exercises, maybe?
Of course, there's going to be there will be changes for everyone. Geetanjali, I think we all can understand our workplaces are usually our second home. So the place where we spend most of the time awake is our workplace. So that is the change that we understand, and we have already started training our staff regarding the same, that they also need to change their way of behaving. First thing, one thing that everyone is going to miss in the entire family is the high five. So we had this high five culture within the facility. If you enter any anytime fitness club, you will be welcomed by doing a high five. So first thing, first change will start from there. And of course, the training method and the while training a client, the trainer needs to take a lot of precaution, which they do understand. I'm happy to share it with you that our staff has those sentiments where they understand that this change is required for their members and for themselves and their families as well. So we've already, all the social distancing norm, we have already started educating our our staff member about the same. Also, while do training, the trainers will be taking care of distancing while they are training a client. That doesn't mean that you will lose the touch with a member. The friendliness is not going to go away. Nobody can take that away from us. But yeah. Yes. We will definitely try and follow the social distancing norm within the staff and within the club.
Okay, maybe pause it for a while.
Yes, pause it for a while is what we are also saying, because the world has paused for a while, and I am sure very soon, once the vaccines will be out, we'll not have to be afraid like this with this virus.
And what about the accessories? It is mandatory for all the people to wear masks. So what about that? Will the gym be providing all of those things?
Maybe gloves or something like that. Gloves. Or sanitizer, yeah, so, probably.
Yes. So as I was just mentioning, that sanitization is something that we will definitely take care of. Mask is something which is kind of a little personal. I'm not sure that whether a member would want to take a mask from the club or no. For all the staff members, we will definitely have masks. for all the cleaning staff and for all while they are the sales staff, when they are supposed to handle the cash and all, there will be gloves which will be provided. We will also have gloves for mask for sale inside the club for a member if they want to take it. But it will depend upon the government norms and rules and regulation. There might be visors inside the club, but mm-hmm. it will depend upon the member sentiment as well. That if they are willing, if they want, then we will try and have it. Or they I'm sure it is going to be one necessity that they all will have with themselves now. Our clubs are usually, you know, we were famous for being 24 into 7 operational. But I would like to inform everyone about the same, that we would want to go with the government norms. I'm not really sure whether they will allow us to open for 24/7 or they will have any restriction, or will there be any restrictions or no. Gitanjali, I guess I missed answering this question of yours, so I'm just picking that up. So mm-hmm. we would want to go with the government norms about the staff, the hours that we are operational. But for sure, we would want to do it, you know, during the staffed hours. We would want our staff to be present and taking care of the members and reminding them about various things that they are supposed to now follow within the facility. Accordingly, the hours of the club would be at different places.
Any challenges at all in terms of government norms that are put up for the normal people and for the normal lifestyle, that you think that this will be a challenge when the gym opens?
Honestly, Alok, if you ask me, I don't think that there is any challenge. You know, purity and hygiene is something which is a virtue. And we in our country are already aware about the same. That is something that has been taught to all of us. Wash your hands before you eat. Wash your hands after you eat. All these things have been some things that we were already taught about, where we were already habitual of. But now if you touch someone and then you're supposed to wash your hands, then it is a kind of change, but it'll just require a little bit of tweaking and we'll be able to follow all these norms to keep ourselves and our families safe. So I think I would like to look at it in a very positive manner, wherein we just have to follow certain things that are need of the hour, and at the same time that can save us from a lot of other troubles and tensions. Along with that, maintaining social distancing is what we are trying to do at the club level. Of course, the number of members within the facility at that particular time will be less. So as a member, I feel that I might not get, you know, every day I was habitual of going to the gym at 6 p.m. Now, I might not get that time every day. There will be some sort of adjustment that everyone has to make. But I think looking at the Indian population, we adapt to change very quickly. And that's the best part about our country. So I am really hoping that we'll be able to adapt to this new gym setup. And we'll be able to get the most of it.
Yes, actually, we really hope to see the smooth operating of the gyms very soon, Richa. And thank you so much for your valuable time and discussing the SOPs in detail. Thank you. Thank you, Alok, for joining us.
Thank you, Gita.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching Crunch Today's YouTube channel. Subscribe if you haven't already. See you in our next video.